This fit on my laser. Yeah, it might fall. About like this. Hey. Actually on the laser? No, we're good. I'm Ed Lester here at Showtime SPL. I got my oldschoolstereo.com mug with my tea, Earl Grey Hot. Anyway, in this video, I want to show you some of my favorites for July. I've done this type of video in the past, some of the past months where I listed my favorite car audio items for that month, and I wanted to do the same here. However, I'm also going to use it to explain what projects are coming up. So a little house cleaning. There's a fly around, speaking of house cleaning. A little house cleaning, and announce the patron giveaway. I chose a patron on my Patreon to give a gift away, and we'll go upstairs in a minute to show that. Every patron, by the way, this month I'm sending one of the Sparked Innovations Base Nerd t-shirts to, just as a thank you. That's a thank you. It wasn't a raffle or anything like that. It's a thank you gift to my patrons. So you see how I have some items here and here and there. So we're going to talk about my favorites real quick before I go upstairs and talk about the patron gift. I did a video just a couple days ago on how to install an alarm and remote start in my crappy car, in the Scion XB. I want you to check that out if you haven't already. Extremely useful, and I watched some of the other how to install alarm videos on YouTube, and they some were horrible, some were okay. I want to be nice about it. So I think I did a really good job. I put some work into it. It's not getting a ton of views, guys. I mean, but you know what? That's okay. I'm starting to shift. Instead of trying to get tons of views and doing more videos that are less quality, I think I'm gonna switch to doing fewer videos that are higher quality because they're helpful and informative. Because even though I don't get tons of views, I have the best quality of viewers out there. I mean, you guys are so supportive and kind, and I get a lot of messages and comments on how helpful the information is, and that's the main goal of this channel, is to spread some helpful information. And if I could do that for a few hundred people versus just making a crappy butt video for thousands of people, then so be it. That's what it is, and that's why I appreciate your support in doing this. Anyway, that out of the way, I'll put a link for that video down below. Let's go upstairs real quick and talk about the patron gifts. All right, so there's the gifts that the lucky Patreon this month gets to choose. Everyone, by the way, on my Patreon will get a t-shirt, Sparked Innovations Base Nerd t-shirt, and a Sparky keychain. They're like a rubber keychain. And here's the gifts you can choose from. A single 15-inch power acoustic Banff. I use that in the $150 SPL challenge. Another woofer I used on video, you can choose to have a pair of the Rockville DJ speakers or a pair of T3 Audio T200s. New old stock. I found these in boxes, so they're unused. Just a nice little 8-inch woofer. You get a pair of those. Or you can choose either one of these amps, 2-channel or 4-channel crunch. Nothing fancy, but you know, they're amplifiers. They get the job done. One thing I don't have here in stock is the Sparked Innovations relay box, the RBX4CH. You can choose that as the gift. Like I said, everyone will get a shirt. I've already been messaging my patrons to get their address and everything so they know what's going on. And whoever I choose, I'll announce you soon. You also get Clippo keychain. Now, Kyle Rutherford is our biggest, highest level patron, and he runs Straight Clippin'. DVSDesigns.com does t-shirts and stickers and Clippo Source. If you know his big build Cliposaurus, he has a big SPL vehicle. Anyway, shout out to him. So let me shout out and thank all my patrons. We got some new ones. Robert Vega, you signed up this month. Thanks, Rob. We also got some so new that some of these guys haven't been processed yet. We got Jeremy Mudd. We got Dustin Souders, Colby Cabrice, Chris Shane, Brandon Banks, all new. Thank you. Welcome to the team. Some veterans. We got William Berg, Tyler Holwinski, Anthony, the car audio guy. Hey, if we want to do a project together, hit me up. We'll do something. Rick Quattlebaum, Lucas Dietz, of course, Kyle Rutherford, Justin Birdie. I already said Justin Birdie. You were one of the new guys. Hey, you announced it twice. Joaquin Juarez, Dustin, you're new also. Dustin Souders, I said twice again. I'm putting my... Now look, here, behind the scenes. Like I said, we're not going to do this formal. I mark the new ones with a line, but I'm holding my thumb over it as I read it. So, I hold it like this. Byron Chambliss, thanks again, man. Brandon Keough, Anton Egertson, Andrew Ryan, and Aaron Hewitt. Thank you guys so much for being part of the team. And see this star here? So that's Josh Darnell. Josh, you're getting the prize this month, the gift I'm going to send to you. It was kind of a random thing. I had my brother help pick someone, and we picked you, Josh. So I'll message you. I already got your address. You get to choose what I'm going to send you this month. Thank you so much. And by the way, anyone else that's on the team, I'm going to try and keep this up every month. So it doesn't matter what level you're at. I'm going to choose someone every month to get a gift, or we're going to try and do that. We'll see where we're at next month. Anyway, let's go back downstairs and finish up this video. All right, that's awesome. And again, that's a gift. Just my biggest supporters are on Patreon. Obviously, they decided there's something being done here that they want to support financially. And you don't have to do that. We might have some giveaways that are more of a contest type thing in the future, but that was more of a gift thing. And thank you guys so much for supporting me in that way. Now, let's get off to my favorites. I have some favorite items here, and some stuff is for future projects. Let's talk about the Sundown X Series. This is my favorite woofer for July. You know, I took a trip to Sundown, so some of the projects I've been doing, some collaborations, I was on Sundown After Dark. I want you guys to go check out. I'll put a link to that episode below. Brian Chamberlain, Jacob Fuller, and all the guys down there. Great guys. Fun to talk to. Right. We had a really good time doing that show. And I got to see some of the new woofers being built, and the whole facility is just freaking awesome. The Sundown X Series, I have four of the 15s. Actually, I got these on pre-sale when the X Series was first debuted. So these are version 1. I'm selling them now. So if they're not sold by the time you see this video and you're interested, hit me up. I got four of these 15s. They were for a project. I really thought they would fit well in my brother's truck in a build we were doing there. He has 8 kids. The truck has problems and we just never did it. So they're all been sitting in the box along with the 1500D amps and a 4-channel amp unused. So hit me up. The idea for us using them is they're just low-end monsters. They're just a big, beefy woofer that can play low frequencies. Might not be the highest SPL woofer, but that's not the point of them. They're like a low-end ground-pounding woofer. Amazing build quality. And the version 2s, I picked one up down there. This one's signed by my man JP. But the version 2 is even built even stronger. And a project coming up I'm doing with this is I'm going to strip it apart, measure out the basket, design my own basket to make out of acrylic, light it up with LED, rebuild it, and take it to the Sundown show, which I'll be there with our booth, Sparked Innovations booth, in late August. So check us out there. Anyway, my favorite woofer this month, the Sundown X Series. Great woofer. All right, now I have some stuff here that is for upcoming projects. And in this build I'm doing in the Scion, I am going to be using Second Skin sound deadener. I mean, that's my favorite every month, so I'm actually not going to show you the deadener. What I am going to show you is my favorite tool this month, and that's the wooden rollers. The wooden rollers from Second Skin, I prefer these over the polyurethane or the rubber ones because the wooden roller, the wooden wheel, is harder and it digs in. so that you can really push that foil back deadener into creases and curves. And you could use the butt of the handle to really push it in. I've shown that in videos in the past. I have a couple videos where I've done that. I'll put links to those below as well. Anyway, I get one of these every order I make, so I have like four or five of these around. Really good thing to keep around for any deadener project. So I got two favorite old school items. I'll start with one. We'll show the other one last. One I'm using for a project, and the other I'm not. It's been sitting around in my collection for quite a while. And this is the Hyphonics Plato Series Equalizer. You can see it's an analog EQ. It's a two-channel EQ, and it uses those analog knobs on the top. Back in the day, this was a really nice piece, and I had wished to use it in my HHR. However, it's not quite up to the standards that I want in my HHR today, and I never got the power plug for it. If I found it, I might just use this on my test bench, or I might sell it off, but this was a great piece back in the day. I love seeing these in builds. Some old school builds still use these because they're just such a great piece. So before I get to the last item, I want to talk about my favorite video in July, and that's my man Bruce, Exo Contralto Channel. You got to check out the coverage from the Access Power Show. Of course, I'll put a link in the description below, but he did this great piece. His footage, the way he edited everything is great, especially the piece he did on Matt from Mechman Matt, where he did this parallel storytelling between the Hearst build and the business itself. And this is a storytelling mechanism used in documentaries and a lot of high-end films. And whether he did it intentionally or not, it just came out great. Of course, Matt was a natural at leading the story the way it went. Bruce is an expert at just capturing it and editing it and portraying it. The whole show he portrayed in kind of the light that the show really is, kind of that spirit, that wholesome spirit. Now, I did lie earlier, although not intentionally. If you lie unintentionally, is it still a lie? Anyway, I do have another item, and it's being used in the Scion project, and that's this excess power wire kit. This is a zero gauge power wire kit. Comes with pre-tech flexed and pre-terminated power wire for under the hood and the ground. Comes with extra terminals, fuse holders, everything you need, even RCAs to install an amplifier. So this is their amp kit. And yeah, a guy like me can just get wire off the roll and make my own stuff and whatever. But I thought this would be great to show off in the video for the Scion. And it's super easy. Everything's right there, ready to go, right out of the box. So I just ordered it, got it, and I'm gonna run it. Actually, tomorrow is probably when I'm gonna film running the wire. So some future projects, again, coming up are the Scion build. I'm gonna do it in pieces. So I'll probably do the amp install in two pieces. One is running all the wire, so showing how to run amplifier wire, and then how to do a custom amp rack with the Incriminator audio amps. Anyway, that's a favorite item for July, the excess power amplifier install kit. All right, and the last thing is something I just picked up recently, and I may use this for the old school SPL challenge. It's this challenge going on, run by oldschoolstereo.com. And of course, Robert Vega on 12V Talk, he's helping run and everything too, and Hi-Fi Vega. And this amp I picked up from Neil Barber down in Georgia. He runs a shop called Audio Extremes. And you know, he has a big blue Ford Bronco in SPL where he uses Incriminator audio, and this thing is just a nasty, awesome build. But anyway, a lot of guys like this that have been around for a long time running shops might have amplifiers that have been sitting around in boxes for years. So this one, it's never been used and out of the box. It's still wrapped in the plastic, has all the manuals and all that sort of thing there. And it's the Audubon Rackman amp. Now, this one's only like a 200 watt amp, but that's okay. I may use it on my test bench in the future, but I think I'm gonna hook it up in the HHR for the old school SPL challenge to my two original 1996 Serum Vega Strokers. Now, these things were kind of goofy, and Audubon was kind of crap back in the day, to be honest. I never really liked them too much, but they were different, and it kind of has a nostalgia to it for me. Where I like their design. And you know, they were just being different. And that's probably the reason why they went rack mount with this, just to be different. Or they got a deal on the rack mount cases for the amps, or they just fit more SPL dust inside. But anyway, I just think it's a cool little thing, and watch out in future videos for me hooking this up. It lights up pretty nice and has the meters in it. It's really cool. I also got the white glove so I don't get fingerprints all over it. So that's all my favorites for July. A little more housekeeping stuff before I sign off. The upcoming projects, the Scion, I'm going to do kind of as a mini build series. It's a crappy car and it's a small build, but I think it would be good to show some techniques and how to along the way with that build. So like I said, I got the wire running video coming up and the amp install for the Incriminator audio amps. Also gonna do the sound deadening with second skin rollers, of course, and some door speakers, some components from Incriminator audio. Also gonna do a custom sub box build with these awesome little 6.5 inch woofers from DS18. DS18 makes them a lot of big woofers and amps nowadays, but the 6.5s were appealing to me for this build, and the red kind of matches the car. So we'll do a nice custom box with those coming up. I can't wait to hear those. And like I said, that's going to be in piece by piece. Along with those videos, still going to do, like I think I was talking earlier about kind of a car audio myth video. That's going to be a collaboration, and a collaboration with the Sundown Unofficial, Derek Haddock, down there in North Carolina. Got something in the works with him. He did a piece for me about his SPL vehicle build and everything, so I'll be able to use that footage in a video coming up. The next show I'm going to be at with Spark Innovations. Remember, my new product coming out is OMI. Go to sparkinnovations.com and to our Facebook to follow along there. We're going to be at the Sundown Audio Show in late August down in North Carolina. And once again, thank you to all my patrons on Patreon. If you are interested in supporting, you go there. If not, that's cool too. A great way to support is go back in some of my older videos, and if you find something useful that you think your buddies would like, share it. That's an amazing way to support this channel and help keep it going along, because I'll put stuff in videos or the whole video centered around something helpful and people might skip over it, you know. But go back, check out the library, and just stick around. Hit that bell notification. If you've been following but are like, I'm not getting, you know, notifications that you've uploaded a new video, it's because nowadays you have to hit that bell notification, that bell icon, to get notified that I put up a video. If you've done that and you are following along, thank you guys so much. I appreciate it. And I hope you're staying. It's hot as hell, and I'm drinking this Earl Grey tea over here, but that's all right. It's all for fun, right? Because this is YouTube. Anyway, thank you guys again for sticking around. May the bass be with you.